Well, November is about to come to an end, but we still have some news to talk about regarding OU football. Number one, this is the time of year where you're going to start hearing NFL declarations, transfer portal, all that stuff. So first off, Eric Gray is going to be playing in the Senior Bowl this year. So all the best of the world to him, man. He was a vital part of this. I know this team went 6-6, but one of the bright spots was Eric Gray. Eric Gray was fun to watch. He made plays. I'm going to miss that dude. You know, it was, again, rough season, but the dude always played his butt off, so I always appreciate Eric Gray. Just moments ago, it made it official. Theo Wease will be entering the transfer portal. Got 2 years left. Disappointing considering how, even though we lost the Tech game, oh, they threw Theo Wease the football. What a shock. And he made some plays, and now he's leaving. He posted on his Snapchat the night before that had a divorce or whatever with the coaching staff. It just didn't seem like things were going on. He didn't get a lot of snap or a lot of throws his way, or it just didn't seem, he wasn't a big part of the offense this year, which, you know, you watch the Tech game, it's like, man, why wasn't he? But unfortunately, this is just how some things work out. And it's disappointing because you look at him, Jaden Hazelwood, and Trajan Bridges, those 3 5-star wide receivers, and Hazelwood was the most you got out of. And at the end of the day, he was a solid contributor when he was here. But man, just really, really disappointing considering how you had Rattler and those three guys, 4 5-stars, and this is what you got from it. So you can't blame Brent on that one. That's the previous regime, although you know who is doing well, and I'll be rooting against him like hell on Friday night because I'm very spiteful, like the rest of you are. So the portal opens up officially on Monday, so if you don't see any names yet, like, there's going to be a lot of, like, you're going to see, like, the Clayton Smiths of the world, the Joseph Wettes and stuff like that. You're going to see some walk-ons that you may not recognize. So there's going to be, again, there's going to be a guy like a Theo Wease that's going to go, oh, that's disappointing. Like, Jordan Mukes is another guy that entered the portal who was only a freshman, so he was a guy I had high hopes for that could potentially do something in that secondary, but unfortunately he just either just didn't like how he was being used or whatever. And that's just kind of the world we're in with college football. If like, if certain players don't feel like they're going to be utilized properly, if they're not going to be part of the system, or they don't think they're going to make an impact on the team, they want to go play elsewhere, and I don't blame them. Like, go, if you feel that's how it's going to go find yourself another spot. But the one thing is, there always seems to be more players in the transfer portal than there are spots in high-level D1 schools. So what ends up happening is some guys overvalue what they're worth, and they don't end up in a decent landing spot. They end up at a FCS level, or sometimes Division II, like, if it gets really bad. So I'm not saying any of those guys I mentioned, like, trust me, Theo Wease is going to find a spot. I think Jordan Mukes will likely find a spot, but It's just the painful truth of the transfer portal. There's a lot of guys out there. There's just not enough spots on, you know, major Division I college football. Okay, so what else is going to happen this week? Well, later today, we will hopefully find out what the Rose Bowl wants to do, if they're going to hijack the college football playoff from expanding to 12 teams by 2024, which would be pretty awesome if you ask me. So I know some of you don't care or hate the idea. I'm all for the 12-team playoff happening as soon as possible. And if the Rose Bowl, like, gets their act together, then hey, we'll have a 12-team playoff. Well, next year could be the last year of a 4-team playoff. If not, we're going to wait till 2026 when all the bowl contracts expire and the playoff committee can run it any way they want, or the D1 schools can run it any way they want. And I have a sneaky suspicion if the Rose Bowl doesn't play ball, they're going to be blacklisted from this thing, and they'll just play a game at SoFi Stadium and call it whatever they want. The Jimmy Kimmel Bowl will be more than happy to be part of the rotation. I've been saying that on Twitter for a long time now. So who knows what's going to happen by the end of the day. I might pop in later on and see what they say, but it is what it is. The 12-team playoff is basically going to be decided whether it happens in 24 or 26 today. So we will wait and see that outcome, and I'll talk more about that later. Okay, so the big news, potentially, is the Peyton Bowen thing might be resolved this week. So stay tuned for that. I'll break it down like this and let you figure it out. The Oklahoma side of things, the reporting, are very, very confident that he's going to go to OU. The Notre Dame side of thing is like, look, I've heard he's going to stay with Notre Dame, but listen, if he goes to Oklahoma, he goes to Oklahoma or whatever. You tell me which one you feel more comfortable with if you're a neutral observer. If one side's like, well, I've heard he's going to Notre Dame still, but we'll see what happens early signing period. The Oklahoma side's very, very confident. I'll let you decide which is which. Hopefully that happens this week, and then we'll get December off to a really good start, and then Oklahoma will jump back up in the top five of the 24/7 composite. If nothing happens, and we still have to wait because there is an in-home visit supposedly planned for later this week, or not, I'm sorry, next week is what I meant to say. Next week there's an in-home visit, so because it's a dead week this week, and you can't do any recruiting anyway, so. But regardless of that, that's kind of what we're waiting for right now, and last day of November, December is going to be busy. It's going to be full of tons of recruiting, tons of transfer portal stuff. So, college football isn't going away anytime soon. Got a bunch of bowl games. We'll find out what bowl game OU goes to sometime Sunday afternoon, early Sunday evening. So, guaranteed rate bowl or whatever it may be. We're probably going to Chase Field and playing in a baseball stadium against somebody. So, oh well. Anyway, with that being said, hope everyone has a good day, a good hump day, and if anything drops later today or tomorrow, I'll be back to talk about it and catch y'all later. Boomer Sooner.